Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, we're gonna dig into the new Sparkline feature in Power BI, and I'm gonna show you how you can take your card visual to the next level. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam, this guy. Okay, when Sparklines were released, people went bananas. They went crazy. It was like, oh, about time, Microsoft. Thank you so much for adding Sparklines to Power BI. I used to use a lot of Sparklines in my paginated reports, but now they're in Power BI. And I wanna show you how you can set them up, but I also wanna show you how you can use them to take your card visual to the next level. So I'm gonna do something different in this video, and I want your feedback. I want you to tell me where in the comments below. Was it too much, not enough, or I need to kind of dial back a little bit? I'm gonna walk through everything I did to take my card visual to the next level, and I'd like to know what you guys think, all right? So enough of all this talking. You guys know what I like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Got this report right here. I published it out, and my report consumer's like, you know what would be great, Patrick? We'd like to see the monthly trend for total sales and period over period change for all the different categories. And so using the matrix visual, I can go to my field list and take month and drop it on columns. So then it's gonna explode out that matrix visual. And that's not gonna be good, because then I have to scroll, and maybe I need to reformat, maybe I change the report. That's not a good idea. That's where Sparklines come in. So instead of adding that month as a column, I just could drop that Sparkline and they could quickly see those trends. I select this matrix, and then you can add a Sparkline a couple of ways, right? I can go insert, add a Sparkline, then I'll get the nice little Sparkline context menu on the y-axis. I'm gonna go ahead and do a quick search. That's what I want right there. And then I wanna get my month. Boom, there's my Sparkline. Once the Sparkline is there, if I go over here to the format option and go all the way down to the bottom, I get some choices, right? I can change it from a line to a column. I don't really like the column, I like the line. And then I can change the color of the data bar if I want to. I can increase the width, which is pretty cool. I'm gonna go up to 2. If I go and you can see marker, I have all these different options. The two that I wanna select, and you can go play with this, right? It's the highest and lowest point. And you can also change the color of those highest and lowest points. I'm gonna make them red. And you can have different types, and you can increase the size. It's wonderful, it's beautiful. And I can repeat this process for the different measures that I add to my matrix. And I don't need to explode it out by adding that month to my column, and now it just kind of fits on this page. It works. What I like most about this is, and if you've been following Guy in the Cube for a bit, you know I write DAX to create those conditional formatting dots on my line charts, right? It's a little trick you have to do. But in this case, I don't have to write any DAX. Power BI does it for me. This is cool. And this is probably the most typical way you'll use a Sparkline. But a while ago, I did a video on creating your own KPI card using Power BI, and I created this little trend line. I actually used bars to do the conditional highlighting, but now I can use my Sparkline to do it, and that's what I want to show you. I want to add this little line right here. I want to add it right under this card or any card I want. So I'm going to go to a blank page. I'm going to add a table, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to take percent over percent change, drop it in the field well, and you'll see it. Expand this out and choose add a Sparkline. You can add Sparklines two ways, right? I showed you a way in the insert in the menu, and you can also add it right here from a measure. It'll auto-populate it with the selected measure from the values, but you'll have to specify the value that you want on the y-axis. And again, I just want month. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose month and click create. Boom. There's my Sparkline. So I'm gonna get rid of this because I really don't need this measure. And what I wanna do is I wanna clean this up so I can use this over on my card visual. So come over here to format, make sure this table is selected, go to grid, and this border. I wanna change the color of this border to match the color of the background on my page. And remember I said I'm gonna show you everything I had to do to get this to work on my report. So you have to tinker with this table a little bit, especially if you're not using a white background, right? It's easy to use white, but if you're using different colors, you need to go find that color. I just use PowerPoint to go find that color. So go to more colors, and so you can see it's already there. Pop it in and then click away. And then if I go to column headers, I need to do the same thing for my text, and I need to do the same thing for the background. And finally, go to format and do a quick search for background, and then look for values, and we're gonna change the background to the same color for my value, and then make sure you look for effects and turn the background off. Now, once you do that, get this shaped up, and then go back over here to my Sparkline, click on my high and low, and make them red. Boom. And then all I'm gonna do now is copy this and then head over to my overview page, paste it on here, and then I'm gonna tinker. Adam and I love to tinker with stuff. Go to view and then go to selection. And then you'll see this table is all the way at the top. I'm gonna move it all the way to the bottom. That way it's always gonna appear below. My card is gonna overlay that sparkline. So now when I publish this out, my report consumers, they can automatically see what the trend is for that value. I added a filter to the filter pane and I made it a single select so they can only select a given year. You can see here in my filter pane right here, I have 2017. If I expand this out and choose 2018, you can see how my little sparkline changes on my card visual. But guess what? I published this out. My report consumers were like, oh, nice, Patrick. This is good. But what do those numbers mean? I want to see the actual numbers there. Can you give me a little tooltip or something? Of course I can. The first thing I'm going to do is select my card visual. I'm going to close this selection pane. I'm going to go to format, to general here, and go to header icons. And I'm going to turn on my help tooltip. And what I'm going to do is say hover over value to see sparkline details. And so you'll see if I hover there, it says hover over the value to see sparkline details. So boom. So how did I make that work? What I did was I created a new page and I made a tooltip page. So page information, allow use tooltip. And I've done some videos on how to create report tooltips. And I just formatted it up. And I wrote a little DAX to highlight the highest and the lowest value. And here's the DAX. And I've done videos on this, but Alberto actually has a really good blog post out there. We talked about highlighting the min and max value. And I just followed the pattern that Alberto put together. And now what you'll see is once I create this, if I go back over to my overview page and I click here and then I go to general and look for tooltips, you can see tooltip is on. I changed the type to report page and I selected my sparkline details. So now if I choose like 2021 and then I hover, you'll see only the months that I have data populated for 2021. Now only can you use these sparklines in your matrix and your tables, but you can use them to enhance other visuals on your report and provide your users with a little more context, a little more information about that visual on the page. All right, what do you guys think? Was that too much? Was it not enough? Let me know, right? Are you using these new sparklines? Do you think they're bananas like me? All right, I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.